everyone. Hate starting the show on a sad note, but we got a couple moments of silence for this one. Now, first we've got former Major League ball player. I remember him when he started out with the Milwaukee Brewers in 1988. Darryl Hamilton. Now, this guy, solid baseball player, 291 lifetime batting average, 13 seasons, finished out with the Mets, and he was an analyst for Major League Baseball Network, MLB Network. Darryl Hamilton, last night, he was shot and killed by his girlfriend, who then shot herself. So it was a murder-suicide, very tragic. I don't know what happened, but the saddest thing of all, they did it in front of a 15-month-old kid. That 15-month-old kid, she did that. No telling what happened. Darryl Hamilton, definitely sad, very tragic. And the folks, that poor kid's traumatized forever from having two parents to having none in a blink of an eye. Very sad, very tragic. Darryl Hamilton, born December 3rd, 1964, murdered June 25th, 2015. Sadly, I don't think we'll ever know the true answers. But in the meantime, definitely going to be sorely missed. No doubt about that. And I feel awful for the kid. I just found out. Thank you, Renee Phillips, my good friend. She always keeps an eye out for our famous folks that pass away. Late Sunday night, early Monday morning, wrestler Buddy Landell, who I remember this guy in WCW wrestling and Smoky Mountain wrestling. And he had gotten signed by WWE in 1995, back when they were WWF, but then he had a knee injury. But he went by the Nature Boy. Yeah, no kidding. There's only one Nature Boy, baby. That's right. Well, there was actually a Nature Boy, Buddy Rogers, well before Ric Flair. Nature Boy Buddy Rogers, but this is Nature Boy Buddy Landell. In fact, the most famous match was against Nature Boy Ric Flair. Woo! That's the Nature Boy to me. But anyway, Nature Boy Buddy Landell, born August 17, 1962, passed away late last night, early this morning. Only 52, just short of 53 years old. Car accident. So, definitely a moment of silence, please, for Buddy Landell and Darryl Hamilton. They will not be forgotten. Alrighty, folks. Well, you know me. I'm not going to have to show on a sad note. That's not my style. That's not the way I do business. Alright, baby. That's right. Let's get the music rolling. Hello, everyone. It is indeed Monday. June 22nd, the year of our Lord, 2015. How are all you doing out there? I am doing awesome as always. Wicked awesome. Hey, it may be Monday, but it's only four more days till Thanksgiving Eve Friday. We'll catch you right. Because you know beer is good for you. You're hot diggity goddamn right it is. And I like beer too. Sorry about the sunlight. Can't help that. Don't have curtains up above there. Today's unofficial sponsor of our show. Hey, why not? Our good friend Priscilla Gonzalez and our good friends over at Barley Hoppers. Ah, great place for some great quality adult beverages. Barley Hoppers. Folks, get out there. Lots of great stuff on tap. A lot of stuff you can't get elsewhere around here. Barley Hoppers, the great place to go for great adult beverages. Hey, some good food as well. Great atmosphere. Great people over there. Barley Hoppers, get over there. All right, try to bust out the Blues Monday beer consumption apparatus. We get our kicks on Route 66. Let's start off with today's beer of the day, Brooklyn Lager. Brooklyn Brewing Company out of Utica, New York. Good stuff. 5.2% alcohol by volume, just a smidge above average of strength. Really good stuff. I swear they were created to be in rival with Sam Adams, and they're both phenomenal. Drive opening apparatus pump technique, here we go. I am Pies, it's been a ball buster of a day. 45 degree grand running in the big substance apparatus, right over the keyboard, because I'm a sad damn good, I haven't closed drop yet. Never have, never will. Beer is good for you. Cheers to beer to all you pros say in Germany, Pies, and say in Japan.
Beer is good for you. Dark or light, it's
brand new.
We're just waiting, go.
Great stuff right there.
Beer is good for you.
Yeah.
Get your tongue tingle and your mind.
A minus? Yeah, I think so. A B plus? Yeah, B plus. Yeah. Really good stuff.
No, beer is good for you. Beer is good for you.
Seriously. And it hurts me to say it. That stuff's just as good as Sam Adams' Boston Lager. And you know me, I'm a proud asshole, and I hate the New York Yankees. But damn it, this is a good beer. I feel like I'm cheating on my own state. Alright, lots of birthdays to get to. Lots of weddings and anniversaries. Actually, weddings. Three of them this weekend. But let's get to the birthday shoutouts first. It's my good friend Di Stevens. That's D.I. Stevens. Fellow Mafia Wars player, Di Stevens, happy birthday to you. Always appreciate your help on the Mafia Wars. How are you? How you doing? Hope you're doing well. Happy birthday. I'll be on the Mafia Wars right after dinner tonight. Got to get on there, ice and fools, because that's what we do. We help each other out. We get stronger so that we can crush the opposition. It's a lot of fun, but nobody gets hurt for real. Longtime Mafia Wars player, Di Stevens, happy birthday. Hope you have a wicked awesome day. Celebrate well and enjoy. Cheers the beers. Yes, folks, I'm doing the show on 3.5 hours sleep. My good friend Justin Derrick made a good point. I look so tired that my bags under my eyes have wrinkles. And that's the truth. Oh. Anyway, next birthday. Comical Nav Wizard Walking Brain of a Lady that I know from good old California, land of fruits and nuts, otherwise known as Southern Oakland, Southern Oregon. Wow. All right, maybe I am tired. I'm talking about the lovely, gorgeous, amazing Jenn Moreau. Jenn Moreau, a great leader of men, women, and it's absolute sweetheart, longtime friend of mine, over 15 years, 16 years. You know, it's funny because she used to live in exotic Japan. Yeah, we know a lot of friends from there, don't we, Jenn? Hell yeah, we do. Jenn living in North Carolina, or as I call it, Southern Virginia, but she's an original Rhode Island girl. Oh, yeah. And a big fan of Beer and Song of the Day. Jenn, you're awesome. Wicked awesome. And happy birthday to you. I know you're having a phenomenal day. You better be. And hey, watch the show. Drake will be right here right now. Happy birthday. Hope you have a wicked awesome day. Celebrate well and enjoy. Cheers and beers to you, my dear. Oh, hell yeah. Next on the list, my good friend Scott Burden. That's B-U-R-D-E-N. Scott Burden. Now, he is friends of a wonderful couple I performed a wedding ceremony for recently. Leroy and Stacy Foley, that's right. And Scott, what's going on, big man? How are you? How you doing? Hope you're doing well. Happy birthday to you. Hell yeah. A great legend of a man that I know down here in Yeehaw, Texas, otherwise known as Southern Oklahoma, pretty much same damn state. Scott, brother. Screaming. Happy birthday. Hope you have a wicked awesome day. Celebrate well and enjoy. Cheers and beers. Next on the list, my good friend Bryan Tax. That's T-K-A-C-S. The K is silent. Bryan Tax. Now, he's a great leader of men, women, and it's badass weapons repair man that I work with down here in Yeehaw, Texas, otherwise known as West Louisiana. That's right. In fact, he's moved on from that job. Now he oversees the entire job site because he's quality assurance, making sure that people do the job right the first time. Safety is the utmost priority. Hey, Bryan, I like to call it quivering anus myself. Why? Because if you don't mess with somebody, it means you don't like them. Dude, you're an awesome guy, and happy birthday to you. How are you? How you doing? Hope you're doing well. I haven't seen you on a job site in a while. But hey, drop me a line, let me know how you're doing, will you? Hope you have a wicked awesome day. Celebrate well and enjoy. Hey, cheers and beers to you. Next on the list. Longtime dear friend of mine that I know from Bakersfield, California. California, land of fruits and nuts, otherwise known as Western Nevada. And she's living in Henrietta, Oklahoma, with the rest of the Bechet family, including her awesome son, Bill, who I've known since 1995. Wow, that's right. And I've known Ruth since, what, 1995 now? An absolute sweetheart of a lady. Ruth, happy birthday to you. How are you? How you doing? Hope you're doing well. And, I miss you guys so much. I really do. And I got to make a trip up to Oklahoma to see all of you. It's been too long. But Ruth, happy birthday. Hope you have a wicked awesome day. Hey, celebrate well and enjoy. Cheers and beers. Next on the list, my good friend Keith Crane. Keith Crane, longtime fellow mafioso on the old Mafia Wars. Awesome guy. Helps me out every single day. I help him out every single day. That's what we do. We help each other. Teamwork makes the dream work. You know it does. And Keith, hell of a great man. Happy birthday to you, my friend. How are you? How you doing? Hope you're doing well. Hope you're celebrating it well. Do what I'm doing. if you ain't driving and you drink adult beverages like I do, then raise that adult beverage high and cheers and beers to your birthday. Hope you're having an awesome day. Celebrate well and enjoy. Cheers and beers. This beer is going fast because I'm parched. Next on the list, my good friend Matt Fleischens, a.k.a. Festa. Yeah, not because he stinks, but because he looks like Uncle Fester. That's right! Matt! A badass bubble-chasing legend, son of a gun that I know from good old California, the land of fruits and nuts, otherwise known as Northern Mexico. Then I knew him in jolly old England. Then I knew him down here in Yeehaw, Texas, otherwise known as Northern Mexico, pretty much the same damn country. And, Matt, I know your wonderful, gorgeous, better half is spoiling you this time the way you spoiled her for her birthday just a few days ago. Dawn is an absolute sweetheart. Farrah and I just love you guys. Not in that way. Don't get excited now. But Matt, you badass mamma jamma living in Missouri, or as those folks there like to call it, Missouri. What's going on, brother? How are you? How you doing? Hope you're doing well. And as of today, June 22nd, your birthday, I got 224. You know what I'm talking about. That's right. Hey, you know what I'm saying, eh? That's what I'm talking about. Oh, Canada indeed. Guys, some love to our neighbors up north, and I do that on Baron Song of the Day every single day of the week. Big day. Matt Fleischens, happy birthday. Hope you have a wicked awesome day. Party hard and enjoy. Celebrate like 1969 minus the acid. Cheers and beers to you. Hey, don't party like we did in 1999, you know. Jungle juice? Oh, man, I'll never forget that day. Good God. Funnel and jungle juice. Ah, good times. Last millennium. All right. The final birthday today goes to my good friend Gage Buzzard. Ah! Gage Buzzard, badass comical nav wizard walking brain of a man I work with down here in Yeehaw, Texas, otherwise known as Eastern New Mexico. That's right. Gage, what's going on, brother? How are you? How you doing? Hope you're doing well. Hope you're going to celebrate your birthday well. You're a hard-working man on the job site. Awesome stuff. Hey, we need more go-getters like you in the world. Hey, so you know what you should do? Be fruitful and multiply someday. Have a litter of kids, okay? Take it from the love doctor. Trust me, I know what I'm talking about, okay? Well, Gage, hey, happy birthday, and a by golly, a big hearty cheers and beers to you, my friend. Hope you enjoy the show. All right, so with that said, let's get to some weddings that we had this weekend. Now, folks, I need the three of you, the three couples, okay? Correct me if I'm wrong on the dates. I'm showing June 20th in the year of our Lord 2015, this Saturday, my good friend Colton Klaus and his wonderful, gorgeous, better half, Shelby May, got married. Colton Klaus, Shelby May, happy wedding day to the two of you, young couple. Hey, my grandparents were young when they got married. My parents were young when they got married. My grandparents stayed married for 72 years. And he passed away at the age of 93. She passed away 71 days later at the age of 90. That's love, baby. My parents, they got married when he was 21 and she was 18, just like my grandparents. They're definitely still going strong. 43 and a half years of exquisite, wicked, awesome marriage. So, Colton and Shelby, hey, make that love strong. Remember, you're each other's best friend. Take it from the love doctor. I know. All right? So, congratulations and a big cheers and beers to the two of you. Hell yeah! And then we got my man, John Peterson. Ah! This guy. A badass weapons repair man I work with down here in Yeehaw, Texas, which is only 40% of the size of Alaska. See, Texas is a cute state. And John is one of the most big-time, wicked, hardcore blues aficionados I've ever met in my entire life. So how ironic I get to give you a shout-out for your wedding, because you married the lovely, gorgeous, amazing Rebekah. Oh, an absolute sweetheart. She's got herself a great man. I'm sure you got yourself an even better woe man. Hell yeah. Now, am I showing correctly it's June 21st? Did you get married on a Sunday, or did you get married on a Saturday, June 20th, in the year of our Lord 2015? And I know you did it in Alabama, otherwise known as Eastern Mississippi. Hey, good blues language down there. You're going to like today's songs there, John. I know you're going to be watching. So, hey, you better raise that adult beverage high with your new bride, Rebekah. And, hey, to the two of you, I say congratulations. And hope it lasts for at least 72 years. All right? Cheers and beers to the two of you. And finally, to my good friends... wait a minute.
Oh, that's it for the weddings. My bad. Yeah. I saw June 21st, 2015, and I realized that was my note for Daryl Hamilton getting murdered. So screw it. Let's just slam it home. Empties the brain cells of an average Los Angeles Lakers fan. Why not? Because I hate the Lakers. I'm a Celtics fan.
Damn it.
Ah! And I'm a New Englander. And this beer from Portland, Maine is absolutely phenomenal. Absolutely freaking smurfalutely wicked awesome. Sea Dog Sunfish. It's a peach ale, folks. Peaches in Maine? Really? Yup. That's right. Sea Dog Brewing Company, home of Sea Dog Blueberry, Wild Blueberry Wheat Ale. Oh, wait, no, that's Wachusett. Sea Dog, yeah, it is. Sea Dog Wild Blueberry Wheat Ale. Not, my bad. Well, they also make a phenomenal peach ale called Sunfish. I've had it on the show before, and I'm featuring it again. It's only 4.6% alcohol by volume. Below average in strength. Not below average in flavor, though. Trust me on that. Proper breathing apparatus, proper technique. Here we go. And, of course, that same Sea Dog paw print beer cap. And as always, 45 to grand right into the beer consumption apparatus, right over the keyboard, some sad day, I'm gonna have a spill drop yet, never have, never will. I'm excited. I needed beer today. Today was a real ball buster. Normally my wife has my balls in her purse, but nah. She let me have them at work, and you know what? They got crushed. They got squashed like a grape. I hope my wife's not too upset about that. Catch my drift? Yeah. Cheers to beers, all you pros, they say Germany kapais, they say in Japan. Oh God, on a hot day like today, this is really refreshing. A phenomenal peach ale, just the right amount of peach. I give that a big solid A. No, I give it an A-. A-. Fantastic beer. I've probably rated it an A before. I don't know. Hey, it's all on what you're in the mood for. Some days a beer's gonna get an A, some days it's gonna get a B plus. It's the way it goes, alright? It's all on what you're in the mood for, my friends. Whew! Alright, so with that said, trivia question time. Sadly, a couple people gave it a shot, but nobody got it right. Because you would think it was paper mache. Alright, let's get to the trivia question. What art word is derived from the French word meaning pasting? I can understand why we had a couple friends of ours, BJ Bonsell Miller and Dan the Man Butler. They both said, Dan said mache, BJ Bonsell Miller said paper mache. You know, good guesses, but it's actually collage. Collage! French for collage. Yeah, well, there you go. Je ne parle pas français très bien. I don't speak French very well, but I can speak it enough to, you know, I can understand it enough to know what's up. So collage is French for pasting. And now you know. If you don't believe me, look it up, all right? So you know what? Screw it. I'm going to drink to myself. A pretty damn good trivia question, wasn't it? Thank you, randomtriviagenerator.com. And finally, I want to give a shout out to my good friend, former admin, but forever will always be a part of Beer and Song of the Day. Love this girl. Living in Hawaii. I know her from jolly old England. My good friend, Sarah Milligan. Sarah Milligan, say baby, what's going on, my former real baby of the day on Beer and Song of the Day, B&E. Former admin, but permanent part of Beer and Song of the Day for life. And I will always take your suggestions, so hit me up. By the way, she's the one that came up with the idea of the memorial album on Beer and Song of the Day, so epic stuff there. That's why we have the moment of silence, because of you, Sarah. Thank you for your support. You support like a double D bra underwire. That support. Sarah, I want to give you the Love Doctor salute. Oh, hell yeah! That's right. Because she's like Smith Barney. She made it the old-fashioned way. She earned it. Yeah, you did, Sarah. Now, the reason why I'm mentioning you is one, because we love you. Sarah and I love you. But two, you came up with an idea. You mentioned something a while back, and I decided that today's beer and hunk. I mean, beer and hunk of the day. Wow, babe and hunk of the day on Beer and Song of the Day. You're gonna be familiar with them because see, you kind of gave me the idea for it a while ago. I haven't forgotten. But let's get to today's vehicle of the day first and foremost. Because today's vehicle of the day, my friends, is a 1961 Lincoln Continental convertible from Jordan, the country of Jordan. That's right. Yeah, ain't that a beauty? Look at that car. Oh, my God. Used by royalty in Jordan. That is a mighty fine automobile. They sure don't make them like they used to. Suicide doors and all that jazz. That is a badass automobile right there. Your vehicle of the day on Baron Song of the Day. Eeny. Now, it is Blues Monday. And when I think of blues, sometimes I think of the harmonica. And one of the greatest heart blowers of all time. That's heart blower is blues lingo for playing harmonica. And John Peterson, I know you know that, brother. Because we're blues aficionados. Sonny Terry, you know that name? You better know that name. Him and Brownie McGee played together for decades. Well, Sonny Terry, who was actually blind, although he wore glasses, so people didn't think he was blind. Sonny Terry, blind, heart-blowing badass. That is your instrument of the day, Sonny Terry's harmonica. I think it's a mighty fine instrument of the day right there, if I don't say so myself. They call it the mouth harp, and rightfully so. So there you go, your instrument of the day on Baron Song Day, and let's bring out a new feature. Thank you, Justin Dimmitt of Prosper. Facebook.com/LLAProsper, all one word. Came with the idea of pet of the day, something I was thinking about a while back. And Justin, you solidified it. So let's bring out today's pet of the day. Why not King Abdullah II's camel? Ah, look at that camel. Ah, he looks happy too. Camels, those, they're crazy creatures. King Abdullah II riding the camel. Hell yeah, probably in Jordan. That's awesome. Let's drink to that, shall we? And don't forget, folks, most of you out there have pets. I would love to feature your pet, whether past or present, as the real pet of the day on Baron Song of the Day, okay? So make it happen. Let's do that. Just like Nike, just do it. Hell yeah! Without further ado, it's time for some music. It's time for a hunk of the day on Baron Song of the Day. And we're going to take it back to 1947. Sonny Terry, you just saw that guy. The heart-blowing badass, one of the greatest harmonica players of all time. And the song's called Whoopin' the Blues. Whoopin' the Blues, Sonny Terry, 1947. As we bring out today's hunk of the day on Baron Song of the Day. And Sarah Milligan, you're going to love this. Because this guy is a badass. That is a king. King Abdullah II of Jordan. And he hates ISIS, which is good because I hate them too. And he is on a crusade to kick the ever-living shit out of ISIS. Because ISIS deserves that. Always. He's also a big-time Star Trek fan. Justin, damn it. I just gave you a hard-on, didn't I? Yep. That's right. Star Trek Voyager. That's where that's from. Listen to that. He's whooping, all right. Whooping the blues. King Abdullah II of Jordan, you're hunking today on Baron Song Day. This guy is one cool freaking king. I don't care what anyone says. This guy is awesome. He's wicked awesome. He's a handsome fella, too. And I know you ladies and you men that love the men love a man in uniform, right? Well, there you go. ISIS, you better fear this guy because he will whoop your ass. A great family man, though. He is. A great daddy. A trekker. Or trekkie, some people call it that. Whether with or without facial hair, the dudes. A handsome man indeed. And ultra cool. I wouldn't piss this guy off. I bet he'd whoop my ass. Probably would. That's a look of, don't mess with me, kid. I'll jack you up. And if I can't beat your ass, I got connections that will. Messing with him is like messing with a mafia don, folks. You just don't do that. Alright? King Abdullah II of Jordan. You're a hunk of the day on Baron Song Day. Yeah. See, folks, remember, not everybody that wears a turban or anything like that is a damn terrorist, all right? Too many people.
think, oh, if they're wearing a turban, then they're evil. This guy's as far from evil as it gets. Hell, I'd love him to be president of the United States of America. At least he's a guy with some freaking balls. We haven't had that since Ronald Reagan. Yeah, I went there. And I don't do politics on my show. Woo! Yeah, so there you go. Your hunk of the day on Baron Song Day. King of Dollar, the second of Jordan. Awesome stuff. Let's drink to that. Celebrity birthdays. Let's burn right through them. Meryl Streep, 66 years old today, as is Lindsay Wagner. Two lovely ladies who are very milfy, matronly ladies. 66 years old. Hey, Justin Dimon, I know you like those two. Oh, yeah. No, I'm not featuring them as baby today at this time. Eventually, I might. Cyndi Lauper. Girls just want to have fun. And back in those days, I think she did because she was wild. But she's actually older than my mother. No kidding. She's 62 years old today. Kurt Warner. Badass quarterback for the St. Louis Rams and the Arizona Cardinals. Devout Christian man. A great family man. Kurt Warner. I'm a big fan of the guy. He's 44 years old today. Carson Daly. Yep, that guy. Carson Daly, of course. He's like an entertainment news dude. He's 42 years old today. VJ Chandrasekhar. Yeah. Remember the guy with the big old dick broom, the big old mustache, darker dude in Super Troopers? Yeah, that guy. He's 41 years old today. Danny Green. Danny Green is 28 years old today. Shit, what was he from? I don't even remember. Actor, I believe. Kris Kristofferson. Country singer. Actor Kris Kristofferson, absolute badass. I know you know that, Renee Phillips. He's 79 years old today. Randy Couture, phenomenal UFC fighter, an absolute beast. 52 years old today. He could probably still whoop 99% of our butts. Ann Kinsler, I'll always think of him with the Texas Rangers. Yeah. Ann Kinsler, phenomenal Major League ball player, 33 years old today. Champ Bailey. A legend with the Washington Redskins and the Denver Broncos. Phenomenal cornerback. Future Hall of Famer, no question about that. 37 years old today. Dan Brown, author of the Da Vinci Code. He is 51 years old today. Freddie Prinze, senior. Not junior, senior. Born in 1955. Sadly, passed away only 22, 23 years old in 1977. In fact, Freddie Prinze Jr. was only a year old when his dad passed away. Awful. Clyde the Glide Drexler. I love this guy. One of my more favorite NBA players of all time. I was a big fan of him. Portland Trail Blazers. Clyde the Glide Drexler. 53 years old today. Ralph Waite. Ah. From the Waltons. Ralph Waite. Of course. I know you know that, Renee. I know you know that, Sarah. Ralph Waite. Born in 1928. Sadly passed away just last year, 2014. I remember doing the moment of silence for him. Tim Russ. Ah, Tim Russ, Star Trek actor. Justin Dimmitt, you better know that. 59 years old today. Phil Hughes, New York Yankees left-handed pitcher. Phil Hughes, 29 years old today. Todd Rundgren, badass hard rock beast, 67 years old today. Pistol Pete Maravich, one of the most phenomenal college basketball players in history. His NBA career was pretty solid, but not like his college career. Well, Pistol Pete, born in 1947, sadly passed away much too young at the age of 40 in 1988. And finally, communist senator from California, Dianne freaking Feinstein. That, I mean, she's beyond. She is communist bitch. I can't stand her. Hey, Dianne Feinstein, you're 82 years old today. Good. You're still a bitch. So there you go. Happy birthday, people. Celebrity birthdays. There you go. Ugh, Dianne Feinstein, one of the worst politicians I know of. She's almost as bad as Hillary Clinton. Ugh, good God. All right. The only difference between Hillary and Dianne, I don't think Dianne Feinstein has a penis. Hillary Clinton, though? I'll bet she does. Anyway, all right, enough of that. So, time to bring out today's baby of the day. You probably know who it's going to be. That's right. Queen Rania of Jordan, R-A-N-I-A, and look at her. Ain't she finer than a new set of snow tires? That is a stunningly gorgeous, beautiful young lady. As we bring out, from 1936, Kokomo Arnold, another heart-blowing badass son of a gun. Shake that thing. Actually, you know what? I confused Kokomo Arnold with Billy Boy Arnold. John Peterson, I caught myself on that. Billy Boy Arnold, who played with Bo Diddley, was the heart-blowing badass. Kokomo Arnold, born in 1901, passed away in 1968. Shake that thing. Yeah. Shake that thing. Queen Rania of Jordan. Shake that thing, girl. Because you're hot, real hot, damn hot. Look at her. She's milking hot. She reminds me of a slightly older and bolder Natalie Portman. It's not about... Well, Natalie Portman's from Israel. Golly. These Arab women are so beautiful, aren't they? I think so. You're from Middle Eastern women. They're gorgeous. And Queen Rania of Jordan. Good God. Hot, real hot, damn hot. We're gonna be smoking hot. And she's very conservative in her fancy dress. She does not dress slutty. I couldn't even find any bathing suit pictures of her. And look at that. Was she wearing a skirt? Proper lady. Legs closed. She's so pretty, though. She really is. Queen Rania, R-A-N-I-A, of Jordan. Yeah, she's plowing the king. It's a lucky guy. It's a lucky lady. Because these two are ultra cool, badass, and wicked awesome. Kokomo Arnold, shake that thing. Queen Rania of Jordan, you shake that thing, girl. I know the king will be happy. Beautiful couple right there. Definitely honored to feature her as our babe of the day on Baron Song of the Day. Feeny. You know, a lot of cool things happen on this day, June 22nd, the year of our Lord, whenever. Whoa, whoa, man in uniform. Sexy. Shake it, girl. Austin, 1995. The United States beat Colombia 2-1 in the 1994 Soccer World Cup. That was the first time the U.S. team had won in a World Cup match since 1950. Unfreaking believable, but very true. Wow. Austin, 1990. 25 years ago today. Where's my Atlanta Braves fans at? Because I know you know this. I know this too. I remember when it happened. Atlanta Braves replaced manager Russ Nixon with general manager Bobby Cox. Obviously, Bobby Cox led them to a phenomenal decade and a half of wicked awesomeness, including the World Series ring. It's kind of surprising they didn't get more, but you know what? Bobby Cox, phenomenal manager with them. He didn't do a whole lot with the Braves, but he kicked ass with the with the Blue Jays. He used to be manager of the Blue Jays before the Braves. So that's the last picture of the day on Baron Song Day. Feeny. Let's bring out the rest of this day in history. Let's drink first, shall we? I was hoping to keep the show under 35 minutes. Probably going to be about 36, 37. I say 1983, the NHL institutes a 5-minute sudden death overtime period. Good on that one. I say 1981, I remember watching this. And I didn't watch tennis, but I remember it on the news. John McEnroe exhibits a disgraceful act of misbehavior at Wimbledon. Yeah. Oh, that was epic. On his day in 1980, Jim King begins riding Miracle Strip roller coaster for 368 hours. Wow, weird. On his day in 1970, President Richard Nixon signs the 26th Amendment. Voting age is lowered to 18 years old, as it should be. I'm down with that. Some may disagree with me, but I think if you're an adult, you should be able to have the right to vote. If you're an adult, you should be able to drink adult beverages. We can't do that in the United States of America. I think it's bullshit, but that's my opinion. Hey, It's just the way it is, folks. On his day in 1959, Eddie Lubansky bowls two consecutive perfect games. That's 300. Two games in a row. That's 24 strikes in a row for bowling, if you didn't know that. On his day in 1944, Franklin D. Roosevelt signs the GI Bill of Rights. That is known as the Servicemen's Readjustment Act. Something that has been epic to all you service members, past, present, and perhaps even future. Awesome stuff right there. Hell yeah. On this day, 1939, the future Queen Elizabeth II of England meets future husband Philip. Yeah, they met on this day in 1939. Now, mind you, he was like 18 years old and she was 13. Ha ha. But they got married in 1947 and she was legal and so was he. And they've been married ever since. Awesome stuff. On this day in 1932, National League finally approves players wearing numbers on the uniform. About damn time. Gotta know who you're screwing, right? Just saying. On this day in 1875, game of lawn tennis is introduced. You really give a shit? I don't. Alright, I've played it before. I call it croquet. But anyway, whatever. On this day in 1873, Prince Edward Island joins Canada. Hey! Hey, Canada! Prince Edward Island. Happy birthday. Of being part of Canada. On this day in 1870, the first boardwalk in America is invented. Probably Atlantic City. I'm not sure though. Doesn't say. Thank you, BrainyHistory.com. On this day in 1847, the donut is created. Yeah! On this day in 1808, Zebulon Pike reaches his peak. That's right, Pike's Peak, Colorado. On this day in 1772, slavery is outlawed in England. Good stuff, because slavery is bullshit. On this day in 1633, Galileo Galilei is forced to recant that the Earth orbits the Sun. He was forced to recant that by the Pope. That's how powerful the Vatican was back then. But, and it took till October 31st, 1992, the Vatican finally admitted that it was wrong. Well, there you go, folks. Good thing I'm Baptist. Just saying. On this day in 1611, Henry Hudson and his son were set adrift in Hudson Bay by mutineers. Yeah, famous explorer Henry Hudson. Yep, him and his son and a few others set adrift and they perished. Very sad. Never to be seen from again. I wonder if anybody ever found the ship. I was looking online last night, couldn't find a damn thing. But you know what? Hey, rest in peace, right? So hey, let's take it home, baby. Empty as the brain cells of an average New York Jets fan. Folks, you know what time it is, right? Damn right, Reverend Dr. B. Folks, time to make a good fetus to head out. So everybody take care. Wicked awesome night and day. Peace be the journey. Don't do anything I wouldn't do. Don't drink a drive. Make sure you drink all you might kill yourself or somebody else. And drinking and driving is dumber than being a Yanks fan. But what's dumber than that? Is being a fan of that waste of a sperm and egg douchebag Justine Bieber. But what's dumber than that, though, is men sleeping with women, or animal abuse, or racism, or people who are on pets, or fake friends, or anybody that supports, defends, or is a member of the Westboro Baptist Church, or ISIS. Things like that are just plain stupid, and definitely deserve a big, fat, GFY. Folks, I'm out of here. I'll see y'all tomorrow with a very special 2 for Tuesday. Talk to you later. Bye-bye. Bye. Bye. I'm hoping it's chili cheese nachos for dinner tonight. We'll see in about 15 seconds. Yeah, baby.